Hi! Today we're talking about dominance. And not the type that you'd use to spice up your relationship, but the one that we have in the Smite. With Season 8, we saw a few changes to Hunter items, one of them being the introduction of a new item in the Morningstar tree, the same tree that also includes Transcendence. This item has enjoyed a decent amount of popularity so far, with people building it at all different stages of the game, and today I'm going to look into that a little bit deeper, because I want to find out if it's actually worth building dominance earlier in a build, if it's worth building it later, and how it compares to other penetration options. First, a quick overlook as to what dominance offers us. The item costs 2500 gold, which puts it more towards the expensive end, and has 55 physical power, which is relatively high. It also gives you 200 mana and 20 MP5. Along with that, it has 10% physical penetration, and the passive provides a further 10% specifically for your basic attacks. These extra 10% don't apply to anything else but basic attacks, so it makes for a unique mechanic in that regard. Since we're going to talk about building dominance at different stages of the game, let's begin with the early game. In a recent Smite Challenger Circuit game, which is basically the highest level of play below the SPL that we have right now, somebody actually built this item as the first full item after the starter on a Hunter. Now keep in mind that the SCC is by far not a low level of play. For example, Adapting was playing in that very tournament. So we are talking about people that generally understand the game relatively well. So this decision initially surprised me and I wanted to look into it further. In order to do that, I put it next to two very comparable items. The first one is an alternative that also provides power as well as MP5, and that is Transcendence. It only costs slightly more with a 2600 gold price tag, comes with the same amount of power if you buy it at level 5 with your base mana included, and also provides additional 300 mana and 10 MP5. So it's half the MP5 of dominance and it doesn't provide any additional penetration. The other alternative is one that is more likely to rival dominance in aggression, and that is Berserker's Shield. It costs the same, with 2500 gold, it provides 50 power, so it is slightly less, also has 10% penetration, and comes with 20% attack speed, as well as 20 physical protections. Now we also need to understand how much percentage pen is worth at this point. Around level 5, hunters would have around 25 to 28 physical protections. So 10% of that would be 2 point something, which in Smite is typically rounded down to 2, to 3 point something, which would be rounded to 3. So you'd have 2 to 3 flat penetration for 10%. That means with dominance, you would be looking at like roughly 5-6 flat pen, depending on the exact target once again, whereas with Berserker's Shield, you're looking at 2 to 3 flat pen that you get out of the percentage pen. That is not exactly a lot, but obviously this scales up throughout the game if the enemy gets more protections as well. And as such, dominance can actually give you a brief aggression spike. It gives you high power, it gives you a little bit of extra penetration, and gives you the highest MP5 here, so if you spam a lot of abilities, then you can get something out of that. Question is, if you spam a lot of abilities, then is dominance really the item for you, because a lot of the amplification factor for later is for basic attacks and not abilities. So if you're going very ability-based, Transcendence is probably a better option, but at the same time, not every build includes Transcendence at the moment. And if you're not planning to include Transcendence, but you want to have Dominance in your build at some point, then Dominance might be a useful choice here. However, if you're focusing on boxing or you plan to get Berserker's Shield at any point, that could be the better option for most, since the overall stats are just more useful for early boxing. You have more protections and significantly more attack speed, which also helps you with clearing. The only thing that it doesn't provide to a similar degree is MP5. So really with dominance, you want to have a more ability-based character that does a lot with that MP5, and that is kind of awkward due to the basic attack focus of the item. As such, I would say there are potential use cases for it in the early game, but you have to know very well what you want to build into later and why you're doing it. So it's a very niche option. And that's a point that we can build off of here in general. Next, let's look at the item in a 6-slot build. So I'm going to use a very default build here that can basically accommodate all the different options that I want to compare to each other, and that's going to be Death Embrace, Devourer's Gauntlet, Ninja Tabi, Executioner, and Kin Scythe. This build gives you a high amount of sustain, it gives you a reasonable amount of attack speed, but it doesn't make you overcap. And then it also gives you Kin Scythe to really get the most out of your basic attacks. As the last item in the build, we include three options here, either Dominance, or what we already talked about, Berserker's Shield, Or as the third one, Titan's Bane, which comes with more penetration, but partially in different ways. Here are the stats for the build and then with the items included. As you can see, the overall damage output is relatively similar between all of them, since they have similar amounts of power. Berserker Shield comes with a little bit more attack speed, and then Titan's Bane has 20% pen at all times, an additional 20% on the first ability, whereas Dominance has 10% and then 10% on basic attacks as well, and Berserker's Shield only has 10%. Berserker's Shield's passive is not included in the equation here, since it is more situational. I think it's a very strong passive, but I don't think you should rely on it for your damage output. I ran multiple comparisons here. The first one was a simple general practice test on the level 20 Odin bot with his roughly 2000 health and roughly 70 protections, which was just basic attacking him with this very build to see how much damage we do across 5 basic attacks, which is when you reach the maximum stacks of Executioner. You can see all the stats in detail here if you want to look at every single hit. The outcome was that with Titan's Bane, those basic attacks with the Kincise procs and your one on Ram combined would deal 1581 damage. With Dominance, the combined damage was 1609. With Berserker Shield, the combined damage was 1545. Keep in mind that Berserker Shield has higher attack speed than the others here, which is something that this number does not illustrate, which would basically put Berserker Shield more on level with the others or higher. And then I wanted to see how much damage you do with 3 shots of Ram's ultimate. With Titan's Bane, we deal 1166 damage. With Dominance, we deal 1020, and with Berserker's Shield, we for some reason deal slightly less, 1017, which seems to be some rounding difference between these items. It should be the same as Dominance, really. But overall, we can see that while we do slightly more damage with Dominance in terms of basic attacking, 20 across 5 basic attacks, Titan's Bane actually offsets that heavily here with more than 100 extra damage during the ultimate alone. This tells us something very important that I was already suspecting, and that's why I specifically picked Ram for this test. Ram has very low ability damage for a hunter and does most of his damage with basic attacks. That is not the case for every other hunter in the game, many of which deal high amounts of damage with their abilities. And that doesn't just apply to Titan's Bane's passive, which gives you extra pen for one ability, but across all abilities you will consistently have 10% more pen than Dominance. Your Kincise will deal more damage. Any Odysseus bow effect that you have will deal more damage. Any other ability effect that you have that amplifies your basic attacks, like Ram's one, will deal more damage. So there are a lot of things that Titan's Bane amplifies, but Dominance doesn't. Now, damage output values are only one part of the equation. We can also look at damage per second. Let's first again take a squishy target on level 20 with 2000 health and with 70 prots. You have the raw DPS values here, and then the ones after the protections. Keep in mind that they're calculated slightly differently for Dominance because it only applies the 10% extra damage to basic attacks. For this first test, we're assuming full stacks of Executioner, so we drastically lower the enemy protections. With Titan's Bane, we have 573 DPS. With Dominance, we have 591 DPS, and with Berserker Shield, we have 622 damage per second. So what we can see here already is that while Dominance has a little bit more penetration, Berserker's attack speed more than offsets that, and again, that is without even including the passive at all. And now let's try things against a tank where pen should really shine, with 3000 health and 250 physical protection. Let's first try out what happens if we have no stacks of Executioner and just rely on the pen from the items. With Titan's Bane, that is 326 damage per second. With Dominance, it's 328, and with Berserker Shield, it's 337. So once again, the attack speed from Berserker Shield is worth more for damage output than the 10% penetration from Dominance. If we include Executioner in order to have a little bit more pen overall, then Titan's Bane's damage is 401, Dominance is at 405, and Berserker Shield is at 418, so it has even more of a lead. So what do we learn from this? Dominance is a highly specific item that only a few hunters can use more effectively than Titan's Bane when it comes to damage output, and it provides a decent amount of MP5, so if that is something you're after and you don't want to go into Transcendence, that could be a reason to build it. When it comes to direct DPS, it basically almost loses to Berserker's Shield, which could be partially pinned on Berserker's Shield just being a little bit overpowered at the moment. So unless that's nerfed, I would generally prefer Berserker's Shield on most hunters, since it has more all-around benefits, really. It doesn't particularly shine with or without Executioner stacks applied, which is important, because sometimes people justify building percentage pin items by the period of a fight where you won't have full Executioner stacks applied, which is frequent, to be honest. But even when specifically looking at basic attacks only, Dominance doesn't do better here than Berserker's Shield, and only barely better than Titan's Bane, which is probably more down to the higher power that the item provides. You could still argue for some other very niche use cases though. One example would be crit builds. Technically, this item supplements a crit build quite nicely to do more damage on your early basic attacks before execution is applied on a target in case you crit. What complicates this is the fact that crit builds will often want lifesteal in them as well, so you're typically looking at something like Devos early, and you very likely want an executioner as well, and then you also want to have a significant amount of crit in order to deal high damage with the crit. So often there will simply not be room for an option like this, or if there is, then it's very, very late into the game. Where I could see some potential in that regard is if the enemy starts building spectral armor, multiple spectral armors, and it's not really worth investing further into crit at that point because you've already got multiple crit items and you're not doing that much damage with it. So you say, okay, I want to do some more damage to those guys as well. So now I build a dominance and swap out my boots for that, for example. But even in that case, for it to be more effective than Berserker's Shield, it requires you to have hit attack speed cap in other ways already, either on a hunter with high attack speed steroids or by building a combination of crit items with a lot of attack speed as well. Only then can you really justify dominance over Berserker's Shield, since otherwise the attack speed from Berserker's Shield will always outweigh the pen from dominance. The other option, which I tried in this video, would be going for a full pen build without executioner, with no protection reduction, just purely relying on the percentage pen from items like Berserker's Shield, Dominance, and Titan's Bane. While this is technically possible, in my opinion it feels relatively unrewarding in the current meta because there are so many strong crit items, there are items like Fail Not, that you all have to somewhat skip for this, and that just doesn't feel good most of the time. Maybe there's a case to be made for this for jungle ADCs to skip stacking Transcendence and get a little bit more MP5 for early clear. That is something you could argue about, but again, it's super, super niche. Generally speaking, I feel like for most carries, Dominance is currently not worth it, and it's most certainly overrated, whereas some assassins like Thanatos with certain combo builds maybe could make decent use of it, but I think Dominance would actually deserve a tiny buff. In other hunter news, with tomorrow's patch, Death Temper will finally work, so we will have a look at the hunter starter items and their upgrades finally. So if you want to see more about that, feel free to sub button and maybe the bell if you haven't yet, so you get notified of it. Thanks to today's sponsor, my Patreons, for making this video possible. Special shout out to Adverse Paladin, That Nick Walker, Donald Dryden, Melancholy Gengar, Dwayne Brennan, Zed the Undead, and Nevitz Jr. And thanks to you for watching. I hope to see you for the next one soon. Duke Sloth, out.